Tinnitus is the perception of a ringing, buzzing, hissing, or roaring sound in one or both ears. It may be continuous or intermittent, occasional, can be pulsing or steady, and can range in severity from a soft buzz to a loud ring. In the United States, an estimated 50 million people suffer from chronic tinnitus lasting more than 6 months. Of these, about 25% struggle with tinnitus severe enough to disrupt their daily routines. Tinnitus is more common in men than women, and is becoming increasingly common as people age. While tinnitus can be annoying, it does not usually indicate a serious underlying problem. There are strategies to alleviate and adapt to these symptoms and reduce their impact on daily life. Tinnitus often arises due to damage to the small hair-like structures on auditory cells located in the inner ear. When these cells are damaged or under stress, they alter the signals they send to the brain, occasionally resulting in sounds heard solely by the affected individual. The harm to these hair cells can stem from factors such as natural aging, exposure to very loud noises, specific medications, injuries, or certain medical conditions. In some cases, the damage might be temporary, but the noise remains permanent. On occasion, tinnitus can be linked to issues unrelated to the auditory system. Conditions like temporomandibular joint disorders, affecting the jaw joint, severe anxiety, or neck injuries can trigger tinnitus. Here are a few common causes of tinnitus. 1. Age-related hearing loss. As people age, it's common to experience hearing loss, often accompanied by tinnitus. 2. Noise-induced hearing loss. Prolonged exposure to extremely loud noises, such as chainsaws, gunfire, or loud music, can lead to both temporary and permanent hearing loss, along with tinnitus. Sudden loud noises can also result in severe hearing loss, pain, or hyperacusis, heightened sensitivity to sound. 3. Other factors affecting the auditory system. Numerous auditory issues can contribute to hearing loss and tinnitus. These encompass the use of specific medications, ossification of ear bones, otosclerosis, tumors within the auditory system, disorders related to blood vessels or the nervous system, as well as genetic or hereditary inner ear conditions. A high-pitched, steady tone, ringing, is the most common form of tinnitus. Other symptoms can include a pulsation that is rushing or humming and varies in intensity with exercise or changing of body position. A clicking sound may indicate a nerve or muscle abnormality. Diagnosing tinnitus is crucial to rule out any underlying, more significant issues. It's especially important for individuals experiencing severe, worsening, or persistent ringing, buzzing, or other ear-related noises to seek evaluation. Depending on the circumstances, additional specialized tests may be suggested. Hearing tests can offer valuable insights into the possible origins of tinnitus. Further examinations, like magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, or computed tomography, CT, scans of the brain, might be required based on the findings from the patient's medical history and physical assessment. The management of tinnitus involves addressing underlying conditions and finding ways to alleviate the tinnitus itself. While there's no universal cure for chronic tinnitus, there are strategies to manage it effectively. Treatment for underlying issues. 1. Hearing loss. Individuals with age-related hearing loss may find relief from tinnitus by using hearing aids. These devices enhance external sounds, making the tinnitus less noticeable. Surgery on the outer or middle ear may benefit those with hearing loss from other causes. 2. Cochlear implants. For severe to profound hearing loss cases, cochlear implants implanted in the inner ear can provide auditory improvement. In some instances, they may also help alleviate tinnitus, but their use is subject to evaluation and recommendation. 3. Medication-related auditory damage. If tinnitus results from medication use, discontinuing the medication can potentially improve the condition and prevent further hearing loss. Always consult a healthcare provider before changing medications. 4. Depression. Tinnitus often co-occurs with depression. Effective treatments for depression are available, and antidepressant medications can help alleviate tinnitus symptoms and improve coping abilities. 5. Insomnia. When tinnitus interferes with sleep, medications or behavioral changes can be employed to enhance sleep quality. Behavioral therapies are valuable for individuals dealing with chronic tinnitus. These therapies include 1. Tinnitus Retraining Therapy, TRT. TRT aims to retrain the subconscious auditory system to accept tinnitus sounds as natural rather than bothersome. Administered by specialists at tinnitus centers, TRT combines counseling with a wearable device emitting low-level noise and environmental sounds. Commitment to the program is crucial, as the noise-generating device may need to be worn for 1 to 2 years. Studies indicate that up to 80% of patients experience some tinnitus relief with TRT. 2. Masking. Masking devices, resembling hearing aids, produce low-level sounds to reduce or eliminate tinnitus noise for some individuals. However, it's not effective for everyone, and some may find their tinnitus worsens when using these devices. Alternatives include listening to gentle music or creating background noise with a radio, fan, white noise machine, or pillow speakers, which can be especially helpful in quiet settings. 3. Biofeedback and stress reduction. Biofeedback teaches relaxation techniques to control physiological functions like heart rate and breathing. This approach can help manage the distress caused by tinnitus by altering the individual's response to it. Some people find relief from tinnitus symptoms when they no longer perceive it as bothersome or stressful. 4. Cognitive Behavioral Therapy, CBT. CBT's goal is to empower patients to manage their emotional responses to tinnitus. It involves teaching coping strategies, distraction techniques, and relaxation methods to enhance their ability to cope with the condition. The impact of tinnitus on one's daily life can differ, primarily influenced by the intensity of the tinnitus noise. Approximately a quarter of those with tinnitus note an escalation in its severity over time. While long-term tinnitus is unlikely to completely disappear, it frequently becomes less troublesome with the passage of time, especially when accompanied by hearing loss.